Before that, I have already asked them to throw in the towel. And they should not have waited even to be asked.
Very good. We would throw in the towel a long time ago. Very good. We would throw in the towel. I listened to you,
General Tinyefunza. Let me now respond to what you said.
No, before that, let me finish this. You see, this is a long-standing argument about we throwing in the towel. Let the movement resign and so on. There must be a viable force to replace us. Unless Kanovesije is now advocating to surrender Uganda to the Amin Days, to Konye. Konye is the only organized person now with arms. He's talking about Konye. So in other words, we should abdicate, we should vacate power and allow Konye to come
but
to power.
But General Tinyefunza, if I could intervene there, you yourself during your testimony at Parliament, you actually suggested that this government should resign. This was your position.
I did. If it does not, and I'm coming to my second point, I did. If it does not reverse or if it does not address some of the inherent weaknesses, which like Dr. Besigye was talking about. But since that time in 1996 when I testified, many things have happened. You see, we should not also pretend as if nothing has been moved.
Things have happened and AM has gotten worse.
No, it hasn't got worse. We have got more victories. Dr. Besigye knows that by that time when I testified, we hadn't gone to war with Kabila. Instead, it was during that time when Mobutu actually attacked us in Mpondwe. He knows, Dr. Besigye, that at that time we had not been directly attacked by the government of Sudan. We went to Sudan and defeated it. He knows that at that time Kabila had not conspired against us. We went there and defeated them. Since that time, you cannot tell me that President Museveni was micromanaging the operations in southern Sudan. Things have changed. However, I will tell you another thing. What was I criticizing? Underspending on the military. If you remember on my testimony, I was saying, how can you send soldiers to pursue rebels when they are lifting what I called gudurias? Those were, you know,
and we saw them the other day, General Tinyefunza. They were wearing rugs.
No,
and they didn't even have the gudurias to carry.
For the rugs, it is different. The gudurias, at least the soldiers get dry ration because there is increased spending of the military.
General Tinyefunza, you were commanding that army in northern Uganda on a budget of $42 million in 1992, and you were able to crush that rebellion. Today, the budget is $160 million. And the rebellion is the theater of the war, and the intensity of the war has multiplied.
Okay.
So you can't talk of underfunding.
Before you divert me, I will answer that in passing. But let me first actually respond to what Dr. Besigye was talking about. For instance, if you talk about the underspending, which I was talking about, the military budget has been increased. The mechanization, which he's talking about to Dr. Besigye, that he was commanding two tanks or three tanks. He knows that we have built capacity, which has helped us to subdue these regional threats which had come. You cannot say that we were where we were in 1996 when I went to Parliament and testified. I testified in my testimony. I did actually talk about the corruption in the army.
Let's come to Dr. Besigye
Let me talk about corruption. Corruption in the army. Dr. Besigye knows the steps being taken about corruption. He's seeing former army commanders and so on being arraigned before court martials and so on. He's seeing very serious steps being taken toward that end. Therefore, it is very disingenuous of Dr. Besigye. Think that where we were in 1996 is where we are still. Things moved. Things are not rosy. Things are not perfect.
But you have moved. So, General Tinyefunza, you have spoken for about 10 minutes. Let me come to Dr. Besigye.
Sorry about that.
Let him respond to you, and then you answer back. Dr. Besigye, the floor is yours.
You see, I cannot understand what General Tinyefunza is talking about, and neither can anybody listening to him, I believe. When in 1993, when he said that the war in northern Uganda was over, that was, you know, he told the whole army that he was leaving Guru, he had crushed the rebellion, it was over. He had finished his job. He was now coming back to Kampala. General Tinyefunza himself told the whole army with an army message with fanfare and pomp that he had finished the war. That was 1993. What happened?
No, Dr. Besigye, you are wrong. That was 1991. And there was no rebellion until 1994.
So what
actually
happened?
The period
did
end.
Because you are saying that the problem is that there was underfunding, the problem was all this. What happened was, when it was crashed, was there underfunding?
There were problems.
What has changed?
Dr. Besigye, there was a problem.
Now have thousands and thousands of Konye combatants killing hundreds and hundreds of people, marauding in Teso, marauding in Lira, marauding in... What has happened?
Is that after 1991, 1992?
Is that an improvement? Is it a regression? What is it?
No. Dr. Besigye, that is being very unfair to us. And
guys, these things never end.